Hello, today I will show you how to use our M1A2 short timer. Okay, firstly, I will show you how to power on. Long press the right button for 4 seconds until you see our brand. This is the home page. Here, this icon means this model is for fire. And here it's sleep time and the total time. Here, press the left button to start timing. See? It can pick up the sound of gunshots and stop timing. Here you can press the review. This right button is also review button to check every shot. The split time here. We can see there are 4 buttons on the timer. Long press the lock button. You see, we can see the volume and also the sensitivity. Here we can press the speaker button to choose the volume you need. There are 3 kinds of volume, and the first class is for self-practice. And here we can choose the sensitivity for picking up sound. Number 6 level is the standard level when the goods is exporting from our factory. Okay, when you finish setting, you can press the right button to come back to the home page. Okay, let's get to see the manual page. Long press the right button for 2 seconds. You will see the manual page here. This icon means back to home page. And this means down to the next choice. And this means there are more details of the choice. Okay, let's see the delay. Delay means how many times you need to wait for the buzzer starts. Instant means the buzzer will start at the same time when you press the button. And the second, random, means you need to wait for 3 to 5 seconds for the buzzer to start. We can try. Long press the left button to choose the choice until you see this chosen icon. Okay, go back to home page. Here we can see, here is the red one. Start. Okay, it starts from 5 seconds. Okay, again. Okay. To check more functions. Here you also have another choice, like fixed. Fixed means 3 seconds, and the buzzer will start from after 3 seconds. Let's try. Every time, after 3 seconds. Try again. Okay, if you think this is still not enough, we also have another function, customized. You can set the customized time here. You can set any time here, like I can set it for 6 seconds back. And please pay attention here. If you want to choose this function, you have to make sure you choose it by long press left button until you see this icon. It means chosen. Then go back to home page and try. Again. Okay, let's try other functions. By come back to the home page, let's check the PAR model. The PAR model is for self-practice usage. And you can set the time and the cycle here. Okay, here for the time, you can set it by minus or plus 0.1 seconds here. And also, if you want more time, you can choose it by the button here. If I set it for 4.5 seconds, okay. And then we can set the cycles. If you want to practice for 3 times, then you can set it for 3 cycles, okay. If we finish, we go back. When you go back, you have to choose it until you see this icon, and then come back to home page here, PAR model, short here, and we can start. We check other functions. Here, if you don't want to use PAR model, please remember to exit it. Same, long press left button. And then we come to the mode. There are 4 functions for this. And this timer can use for fire shooting, airsoft shooting, used as a stopwatch, and also used for counting down. Firstly, for fire, this icon means there are more details with this function. Long press red button. Check the filter and the sensitivity. Filter means the timer has the function to filter the environmental noise. Make sure the timer can only pick up the sound of gunshots. And the default number is 6. If your gun is a rifle and its sound is much bigger than normal handgun, you can make the number bigger. Like you can set it as 8, so that the timer can pick up the sound more precisely. And for the sensitivities, the default number is number 6 for normal handgun and rifles. And same, if your gun sound is very big, then you can choose a smaller level, like level 5. But the general setting is for number 6. So if everything is okay, please do not change the setting here. The default setting of filter is 10, not 6. I just made a mistake. Okay, it's 10. So no need to change it. Okay, let's come to the Airsoft function. This function will be only used when you have a stop target to connect. If this timer is only for your fire shooting, then no need to set it. Okay, let's go to the stopwatch. The stopwatch function is like normal stopwatch functions. We can try and we choose it first. Here, go back to home page. See, the icon becomes stopwatch, and you can stop timing at any time you want. Stop it. Okay, last but not least is the countdown function. This is an outstanding function. We designed it for the all-in competition. Let's check it. Countdown is normally used for the shooters to walking through the stage before the competition. And we can set the time for like 90 seconds, so 1 minute, okay. And then we come to the second, make it to 30 seconds. Then total is 90 seconds. Okay, if you set it, go back to home page, no need to choose here. go back to home page, and here is a short kit for the function. The minus button in the home page, long press it to start countdown function. See? The buzzer will start in the beginning, and then it will start again when it ends. Okay, let's come to system settings. Firstly, for language, there are two languages. First, the Chinese, second, English. And then for the eco mode is for saving time, saving battery for the timer. Normal means the timer went power off automatically until the battery is used up. And customized, here you can set the power off time. You can set it like 5 minutes. If the timer is not in use for 5 minutes, the timer will power off automatically. Okay, here comes to the RFID. This function is only for wireless timer. If your timer is wireless, there will be a Wi-Fi signal here on the home page. If not, it means your timer do not support wireless connection to special Pi, wireless LED display or stop target, just like this timer. This timer do not have a Wi-Fi signal here. It means this function is a wired function. Okay. Let's come to the RFID to check it. Timer means the timer in your hand, and you can change its RFID here. Dot screen means wireless LED display, and it is also called big scoreboard for timer. And the target means stop target, and this is for airsoft shooting usage. Normally speaking, if you buy our timer and LED display at the same time, all settings will be done before delivery, so they can get connected to each other automatically after you power them on. Therefore, do not change any settings of RFID when you receive it, unless the connection may be not working. Okay, here I will show you the wireless connection between the timer and the display. See? Power on the display first, then power on the timer, then you can use it. Okay. This is the stopwatch function. The display will simulate all the functions, all the data on the timer. And here, let's try the other functions. Try the file. Okay. See? Can try to give it the time. So this is very, very convenient during the club shooting and also the competition. The ROs and also other shooters can see the time, the scores easily. Okay, stop here. And also, this LED display support power bank power, so it's very convenient to use. You can take it outside and to the outdoor range. Well, except the functions, I also like to show you more details about our timer. Here is the mic for picking up sound of gunshots. And here is the USB charging interface. And for the back, here is a hook. So you can hang it on your chest in case you forget it. And there are two holes here, screw holes, for fixing the belt clip. So just like this, so that you can fix the timer to the belt when you do self practice, and it will help a lot when you check the time like this. You fix like this and you check time like this. It's very convenient. And additionally, the belt clip is not standard accessory. So if you need one for M1A2 short timer, you can contact our salesman. And for the power off, same as power on, long press the right button, this button, for 4 seconds to power off. See? Same, see our brand. Okay,